All right, Joe. One love to everybody in creation. Sun, moon, and stars. Planets, earth, gods, devils, angels, demons. This is the Supreme Style movie by Conspiracy the Cutslinger. We got some graffiti for you people to check out. Yo, I'm a Canadian celebrity, and I've been in the hip-hop culture for like 20 years. I've been rapping, rhyming, writing my own lyrics for like, since 1996, put it that way. And I got futuristic next level intelligence, divine consciousness, spiritual soul, creativity, whatever you want to call it. That's what I put into my artwork. Because really, that's all that you gotta make. It's not about copying. Gotta be new, original, fresh. Like some of this graffiti. They make statements. They write their names, colors, shapes, sizes, lines, letters, you know? Honestly. You can do whatever you want. You can use all kinds of styles, pictures, images. Real, dream, fantasy, fiction, science fiction, science fact, pattern. Look at this, it's like a honeycomb. Water, and it's like a squid. Yo, it's like so many ways you can do it. Vancouver, Montreal, Toronto, you see that? Yo, shout out all these cats. I'm representing for Toronto, the city where I'm born. Conspiracy, 2012, Age of Aquarius. Look, shout out to all the Christians, representing all religions. It's about love. Doesn't matter what you look like, what you believe in. God is all colors. God is the rainbow. God is Islamic. God is Buddhist. God is, you know, every religion. God is whatever you want. God is female. God is animal. Look at this boxer. You could do murals, you know what I'm saying? Like, shouting out people that you love. You can do abstract stuff like this. There's some weird faces, you know what I mean? Straight up. These guys got like so much creativity. They can do whatever, man. And like, honestly, it takes hours, it takes weeks, it takes months, it takes years. You gotta like come up with the idea, then you gotta like sketch it in your black book, then you gotta like get enough cans, all sort of color schemes, then you gotta like plan it out, you know. There's a science to it. It's not just like some, they're trying to say graffiti's not artwork, graffiti's not real creativity. How could you not see the soul in all of this? This is This is one of the four elements of the most powerful entertainment style in the world. Graffiti of the four elements of the hip-hop culture. Then you got DJing. You wouldn't even have clubs to play music in without DJing. You wouldn't have rappers to sing your favorite songs without MCing. You wouldn't have dancers to dance to your songs. I mean, hip-hop is like the soul of the party. The pleasure. The positivity. Like, come on now. Ugly, nasty city. You see that? Yeah. Also the names. I don't want to say any names too much. I already use enough names in my rap. But, you know, this is beautiful. Like, you got, like, you can express, like, the deepest meaning in a picture. And you can, like, leave it there forever. Who writes this shit? Pardon my language. There might be a bit of swearing in this movie. Cause I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Grandpa. Yeah. Yo, see that red and pink and white? Beautiful colors. And it's like, look at this. This is my favorite piece out of all of these. This alien one. Extraterrestrial, look at it. Come on now. This is the most creative and emotionally and visually, imaginarily artistic art form that there is in all of, well, other than like abstract art basically. But I mean, graffiti art, there's many kinds of art. There's portraits, there's other kinds of stuff, but to me, graffiti is the most extreme. It's got the most crazy and creative and cool and conscious elements in it. Look at this, comedy. They got jokes, they got, it's for, it could be for kids, for adults. Look, laughter solves depression. They make like political statements. That's like some therapeutic humor. You know what I mean? Like, for your, like, uplifting your mood because you want to, like, get out of, like, a bad situation or, like, feel better about life. So you can express it through your artwork. And that's why they write laughter solves depression. You know? This is, like, so good, man. I love graffiti. And, like, it's infinite. It's, like, 16 million colors that you could use. Like, there's never going to be an end to the amount of art. Look, a fairy. Better capture this on camera before you never get to see it ever again in eternity. Yeah. You know, it's got like a tree back there, and like a girl in the sky. Look at that in the moon. That's so good. so good. It keeps going and going and going. Look at that this time. That's so funny. Yeah. Cartoon stuff. Come on now. Have a sense of humor. That's what art is for. It's gonna be happy. CN Tower in Toronto. Got the like city skyline. Straight up. I'm doing this in the rugged urban streets. Listen, study, develop. They drop wisdom, intelligence, consciousness. Another type of consciousness. It's like educational consciousness. Got like some Asian artwork. A dragon. It's crazy. Look at that. Look at that. Yo, that's the next level stuff. Next level stuff. Got like Hannah Montana characters. Like I mean, shout out to Warner Brothers, Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, Roadrunner, Tweety, Sylvester. Your family, Sam. And all the cartoon characters, even like Wile E. Coyote. Look at this. He even got like Roadrunner. Extraterrestrial, like next level people. Yeah. All of it, you know. And it don't stop, and it don't quit. The Simpsons. That brings me to more cartoons. Even like Bart Simpson, Homer Simpson, Lisa, Maggie. Bird, Bo, Officer Quimby, graffiti is illegal, you know, look at Bart getting caught by the cop and he's eating a donut, dude, that's funny, that's the next level shit, oh, I love that alien one, remember that extraterrestrial one, look at this, if they do portraits of like beautiful women, you can have like female graffiti, male graffiti, unisex. There's no, not like dominated by maybe one type of person or individual. Like, oh, look at it. This person's good. This person's really good. That's the West Coast. And look, this is like probably about 20, 30 feet high, yo. On the real, like, not even like, that's like a small picture, that's gigantic. When I get to the end, I'll show you how close I am to it. Yo. I love stuff, complex characters and the letters. This is a visual picture expression medium that deals with lines, shapes, sizes, and basically calligraphy. Look at this. When you're writing your name, it's calligraphy. Oh, I love that, man. Look at this. And then there's, like, trademark characters, like, like some graffiti artists have some stuff that they always do in like all their pictures. And like Uber 5000. Look at this, this is pretty good. Shout out all these cats. Probably from all over the world. And like, there's more and more and more of it. If you graffiti in the alley, treat it like it's true artwork. This isn't even like, is this a joke? You're doing it for fun. These people get paid thousands of dollars sometimes to do a legal piece, or they could like pay a lot of money just to put up a bomb or a couple of tags all over the place, and, you know, they represent for their culture, they represent for their crew, it's like graffiti crew, shout out all the cats in graffiti crew, they represent for their way of life, they represent for their neighborhood, they represent for their city, they represent for their people. So yo, just show love, you know? Just art, man. You can't hurt anyone doing this. Yogurt. Oh, look at this one. This is like a portrait piece. That one's nice. This one's really nice. Yeah. Got the lizard. This shit is like fucking 30 feet tall. Look at how tall it is. That's the ground. It goes up that high. Alright, yo. One love, supreme style. Conspiracy in the name of the Most High. Peace. Okay. Here we have another piece in Toronto. This is on Queen Street. And this piece is really big. Look at all this. This is like really big, and it even goes up further and further. Yeah, look at it. More graffiti like this around the world, it would be such a beautiful place. And there is in like France, Germany, Japan, Italy, Spain, South America, certain countries, Brazil, Venezuela, Australia, Britain. There's tons of graffiti. And a lot of guys do stuff like this. You know? Creativity from the soul. Supreme style. Yo, man, it never ends. It's infinite. All the colors of the rainbow. You know what I'm saying? Look at that. That's the whole thing. Alright, yo, one love, man. God bless. Use them pens and pencils and them markers and them graffiti cans. Keep creating them pictures. It's all about the color. We got some nice graffiti here, but there's a bit of construction going on. See that down there? And this here, site. Even got this. Head down there somewhere. Alright. Got this. This is okay. Still some complex futuristic style type. See, and that's what you analyze. The styles of the lines. Whether it's like old school 80s. Bubble letters. Abstract art, whatever, you know? Yeah, and then you even have motherfucking punk ass bitches that draw and like just write over, tag over other artist pieces and shit. Fuck them punk motherfucking bitches that be fucking up other niggas' artwork and shit. Look at that. That's some next level shit too. Alright, yo. One love. Keep it real, supreme style. 306 brutal addiction. Like me fucking wanting to legalize marijuana. And all sorts of other chemical substances that you could ingest for recreational purposes. That you could partake in for recreational purposes. To be more specific. Another really good piece. See motherfuckers right now loving their pieces. See graffiti ghettos, like from the streets. I mean, you're doing this outside, there's no protection, it's like the four elements of nature, water, sun. You know, if you get all dirty and shit, and you got like simple pieces that are just one line, two lines and shit, and you got like tags and bombs and shit, but I like them real colorful pieces. And you got like this cartoon characters and shit. You know, I'm all for legalization. Most graffiti artists use like acid or heroin or many other kinds of drugs before they use the pen or the spray pen to do a piece because they like to have some sort of like internal chemical stimulation to do it. So just grind that complex even. Something that's cool, yeah. I'm ready to do it.
Toronto, underground, Queen,
already from art school, graduated.
The block, my mic's a plot. I can put it down and stop. The way MCs react with all your talk. Get me away from them, he's a conspiracy. I've been framed, they call me nigga so much. Starting to think it's my name. Light skin and shame. Cause way back in the days, they raped my grandmother's mothers when they was enslaved. They hung my grandpa, they be misbehaved. But my ancestors was brave and most of them real. Strong, hard, black, sweaty slaves working in the fields. 100 years later, I learned about my roots and how they traded in they white sheets. So I'm taking retreats at the fucking score right. Start a fight, a fight, a nigga in a white. If the nigga don't win, then
you're the best. Look at that motherfucker wearing glasses. Some other character. And then you just got the funny comedy cartoon pieces, the big like Childish, Bubba Letters and stuff, old school 80s style. Alright, one love. Supreme style. Gia 2012. Spiritual side to graffiti too. When you do them drugs and go to the dream world, see God, see spirit, see all sorts of shit. You see like visions, pictures, environments, and you see like worlds and galaxies, planets, animals. You can see anything. So on the real, just know that there is no limit to this. Cause you can go so high that it's infinite. There is no limit till no. Look at this artwork, man. Look at this artwork. This is so beautiful, and you can have this all over the world. You know it's worldwide. It's totally worldwide. I wonder what alien artwork would be like. That's a classic color. And the neon green. You know they love them colors. Alright, we just got some guy mystery shit. Alright. That's about it. Right, this is one of my favorite writers. No, this is a site to somebody else. M-A. Okay, and what? I don't even know what that says. Oh, it does say sex. Yeah. Sometimes it's hard to read because it's so complex. You can make something complex. And like, I've even done artwork that I can't even read. You can be like that, I'm motherfucker. Yeah, I'm glad it wasn't sex. Because I thought I fucked up this time. That I thought the piece of writers that are too complex and you get a readable shit with the abstract Christmas. Got the pink and the blue. Yeah man, and God allows artwork. There's nothing illegal about this. You can't even bust that argument. I mean, the only thing is if somebody tags up your property and it's like your house or something, like, that's your private property. No one's gonna do that. But public property, you know, considering that this is stolen land and the ancient religious and spiritual implications of politics, people should be allowed a lot more freedom in society to create and do new things with their minds and their abilities and their God-given talents. Because, like, it's infinite. Look at this. Too bad the gates here. Yeah. You got that one. You got this shit. Yo. And it don't stop, and it don't quit. Look at this dog. Look at that puppy. That's a nice dog. Got the bubbles. The CD, they're gonna put up new artwork too. 2-3 years, this shit gets old, they put up new shit. You know what I'm saying? Awesome. It's a plane. Nice Toronto skies. It's a nice sunny Wednesday in the winter. Canada. Classic celebrity acting magic creation. Yo. This shit don't stop and it don't quit. Multiple styles. Old school, new school, three-dimensional, two-dimensional. Abstract. Weird alternative. You know. And that's about it. Yeah. There's even more. Try to get everything in one shot. Until they put up the next guitar. One more. Yeah, we got this graffiti right here. Shout out to the underground rebels and the vigilantes and the criminals and the revolutionaries that put up messages for us to read. Sometimes they got messages on this shit that's like really important. And like, J-A-Y-K-E. Yeah. See, that's part of the fun too, deciphering the graffiti. Deciphering the graffiti, you know? Like a picture puzzle, technically. Technically it is. You got this shit. You got these weird googly eyes. Oh, look at this cat, nigga. This crazy blue cat. So you could draw weird shit. Your limits are only your imagination. Yeah. This is really beautiful. Blessed artwork. Got the old Native Indian lady. Even could have like browns and oranges and yellows and pinks and greens. Yeah, look at this shit. We're just taking you on a path, a journey, giving you the guidance. Oh, I like this. I like stars. Red star. Yeah. Look at that. Oh, look at this. The two elk. Look at that shit. Look at this shit. Shout out to all the graffiti writers out there that see their pieces up in here. I mean, we may actually have some people that recognize stuff that they've done. We've got the urban scene. We got the pink and the red. Dear Mama. Yeah. I got a black book and I used to do a whole bunch of pieces, but I got into rhyming. I started MCing and shit. Yeah. Look at that, yo. Yeah. Alright, one more. Keep a cartoony character comic bookery. Look at that, yo. Ain't that some shit? Shit is just hardcore. Look at this gangster. pimp with a cane, nigga. Look at this nigga. Oh shit, I wouldn't mess with that cat. Play on, player. Alright, we're getting to the good stuff. We almost getting to the end of this chapter. I'ma be just really going slow so you can take this all in. Freezing my motherfucking ass off, giving you some graffiti to look at. Yo, my rhymes are fat, next level underground. I like black cats. The sound is divine because I got another rhyme that I thought in my mind when I show you that it's on the lines of reality and fucking brink of destruction, which leads to the other side of creation. Pounding over the motherfucking drum percussion because I show you that I am an angel that has mastered elevation and ascension. Motherfuck medical marijuana, smoking leads to metaphysical meditation. I have the intelligent invention with some next level correct flow that you can check on a record when I scratch it. Yo, I got some other flow that nobody knows. Stay on your toes because if we sound bad, you better have your mind mastered or you get your ass blasted the fastest. I'm a mat, bitch. Relax. It's ridiculous. Ill, stick with it. Just rapping. Killing it with the flow. Intricate. Triplicate. Motherfuckers know that I'm twisted when I get sick. Like puking up shit. Respect to every nigga all up in this bitch, nigga. Yo, my dick is bigger, and I got a quicker trigger finger. Even when I'm fucked up and imperfect, I still come divinely pristine. Yo, I got another rhyme I didn't write in my mind. But still, grimy kid fiend. I'm making this up. Half time, going double time over the beat. Breaking sluts, cunts, because I'm rhyming. So motherfucking materialistically rich and expensively sugar sweet. Doing it deeper than the bottom and higher than the top. In the city of Toronto, I sell CDs on the block. The rap game reminds me of the crack game. Niggas in it for pussy and profit. I'm cool. One black b-boy. Motherfucking astronomically atomic. Sonic sound is supreme style. I'm showing you while I'm doing it. You ruin it, I fix it. I'm the nicest, you're the cruelest. Still any villain, I'll kill, kid. Blitz bitches, lick piss. My children is chillin'. I could blow up a motherfucking building with a snap finger decision. I hit the spot. Drop it. One time for your motherfucking mind. Visual thoughts, optics. I don't give a fuck, nigga. Revolutionaries rebel and do crime. So when you hear conspiracy, rocking a motherfucking style that is supreme. He lets you know that with the flow, I'm a dream king trying to find a queen. Yeah, that's just a freestyle. I'm fucking around. Still looking at all this graffiti. It's just different. They changed it. There was a whole bunch of other shit here before. You may have seen it in a previous conspiracy release. Angelic space alien. Oh shit, Tom and Jerry, nigga. Shout out all the cartoon characters. Tom and Jerry, Beavis and Butthead, Ren and Stimpy, the Transformers, G.I. Joe, the Simpsons, Family Guy, Archie and Betty and Veronica, and Reggie and Jughead, motherfucking He-Man, X-Men, all this shit, yo. Look at this. Wonder Woman, Flash, Hulk, Thor. Evan Van Dam. Leave him Van Dam. Let me say that. Blah, 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 blah. Leave him Van Dam. See that? Look at that, Tom and Jerry. I thought it said heaven. Something about heaven. No. Just leave him Van Dam. Yeah. Alright, this motherfucking mouse running away with the cheese. You got that, see? Shit. Yo, get that cheese, nigga. Get that cake. Alright. One love. Sometimes they keep it transparent to like all sort of other like crystal clear and stuff, a lot of black and white, you know, outlines and like, it's infinite, bro, infinite. Look at this dinosaur right here. I love tags. There's millions and trillions and zillions of tags all over the place. All sort of people just scribbling their name with a marker. Just like throwing up their name. That's a tag right there. I like this. And this is Toronto graffiti. Some of it's old, some of it's new. But, got a Triceratops. Last night they were here. Oh my god. You know what I'm saying? Next level. Yo. And that would take a couple hours, maybe like 4 or 5 weeks. Coming back to a multiple parts of it, you know, you gotta do the outline, you gotta do other parts, you gotta like fill it in, and you gotta do the details. God bless graffiti. Yo, I like this here, you got the yellows and the greens and the gray and the black and the white, the complex lines, and it's got like the fire effect with the green. This is really nice. Really like this. I seen this. This is still downtown Toronto. And you even got more around the corner. Look at this. Really tight, yo. The crazy abstract stuff. Like, imagine if the whole world was covered in graffiti, a lot of it. Some parts you would just want to be normal, natural nature, you know what I'm saying? But, like, yo, graffiti's excellent. then you've got just this ghetto shit. Ghetto shit. See, look, shout out all these cats, yo. Shout out them motherfuckers and them motherfuckers, yo. On the real.
This piece is big. Like, really fucking big. Got the purple and the fuchsia and the silver. That's just gigantic, yo. And you got like all these things. You got like the Nightline City skyline. Got all the letters of the alphabet, A to Z. See, they just repping letters, star symbols, you know, goo. Somebody doing a hand, that's nice, eh? That's tight. I couldn't even draw that with a pencil. Be back soon. Yeah, look at this. Alright. Zip. Toronto, though wonderful. Yo. This is right by the Parkdale Library. Some people may know this piece. Pretty nice. Got the whole city skyline. Queen Street complex, you know. And it's just getting better too, you know what I mean? Just getting better. By the liquor store. The liquor store, the LCBO, nigga. Well, I bought my juice. Got the purple and the pink. It's kind of grimy back here, but still, I got some nice, look at this. That's pretty complex, got the pyramid size. The alien ship. Extraterrestrial life forms exist in the universe. Look at that. That's nice. No! Shout out The Simpsons, Homer, Mr. Burns, Nelson, Milhouse. All of them, man. This is really good. It's complex. Beautiful sky. But back to the graffiti. Toronto got a lot of art in it. It's got soul. It just gotta represent it more on a higher level and do it bigger and stronger and better every time. Compete with the Americans, compete with the Europeans, compete with the Germans and the French and the Spanish and the Italians. Italy's got some nice graffiti, straight up and down. Look at this, the green and the blue and the purple with the yellow, and then the beige and the, you know, it's just like, whatever you want it to be. Alright. Look at this motherfucker. See, look at this. Aquamarine blue. Light blue. Oh man, that's beautiful, man. Got the white monkey here with the pentagram on him. Even the horn hands, that's pretty demonic actually. Yo, I got this. Yo, man. Hell yeah, global warming. Yeah, that means new world systems, new energy systems. They need to start developing solar energy and water-powered and electrical and battery-powered. Straight up and down, yo. To be continued. Alright, beautiful red and white here. We got all these pieces, yo. This is really nice. Yeah, like I was saying, solar powered, like, oil and gasoline are okay, but they're finite, they're not infinite, they're not renewable, they're not recyclable. So, the world, mankind system's going to have to develop better ways to have energy to use for resource consumption, for life sustenance, for survival. You know what I mean? Look at this. This is really nice. Got the, like, Grim Reaper character here. Actually, he's just a graffiti artist with a flag, but he looks pretty evil. Yo. You got more and more and more and more and more. Yeah, alright, we're gonna check out some of this stuff. Got all this right here. Even this graffiti. Yeah, man, and you get into, like, just lots of color blending and stuff, you know. People write different words, do different designs, different patterns. You can date it and stuff, see that 2011. You can shout out your friends, look at this. Stencils, they do stencils. Yeah, there's an eye in it. Yeah, this guy's pretty big, and then they get famous, you know. You get a big name off doing graffiti. You really can. Look at that monster. Got the grimy shit. I mean, shout out all the ghetto graffiti artists. Aye, one love. Supreme style. Three-dimensional, four-dimensional abstract pieces, multi-layered pieces. Same name, site, seen him in different places. Yeah, look at this. Really complex, intricate, tiny little details and stuff. Cool, you know? Look at this. And it changes over the years. People make jokes and stuff, you know. Yeah, you got this guy. Look at this guy right here. You got pigs, flying pigs. What the fuck, flying pigs? You serious, for real? You got this here. Miola. Alright. Now we got something. Look at this. This is a nice piece. Yeah. It's really good. Complex. King Kong. How long would it take to do this? couple of days, you know. Dope, yo. And we'll end it on that note. I mean, it gets cartoony, but it's... Alright, Joe, check it out. Graffiti started, you know, years and years ago, 60s, 70s, 50s, and like alleys. They were using it to like just communicate with each other. Motherfuckers. Doing graffiti on subways. I don't know the full story of graffiti, but I do know that over time, a lot of artists have represented with their name. And yeah, I do know that it was a lot of trains, a lot of freight trains, a lot of walls, and a lot of alleys that have been covered in graffiti. And really, to just to express yourself, it's to leave a mark on the world, to leave your name, it's to draw some art. You got the purple and the red and the blue and the yellow with the black background. Got the little painter babies. Yo, next level shit. And it gets dangerous. Motherfuckers are doing graffiti and like the ghettoest places hurting themselves. Motherfucking falling off bridges and shit, electrocuting themselves. Look at that shit. Better get the fuck out of here, nigga. Look at this shit. Yeah. Got this fat gambler. It got the abstract weird. That's what I wanted to get into, the alternative arts. The, like, graffiti. Look at this. It's not even normal. It's all aliened out, like, spaced out and shit. Got the purples and the blues and the... A lot of stuff. Look at this, got the square, like construction type letters. Got the maroon and the... A lot of shit, man. On brick, surfaces and shit. Got the silver, of course, obvious silver, gold, bronze. Black and white, you got your basic colors, red, blue, green, yellow. Then you get into your other colors. Look at this shit, pink like a motherfucker. Yo, grass all over it. Some graffiti pieces get old and shit. Yo, respect to this one, still. I don't even know where a lot of them stay, really. And then you got this one, kind of cloudy. Oh shit, I know where the good shit's at, yo. This is pure Toronto shit. Yeah, got the like neon. Could have like fluorescent colors, neon yellow, neon green, neon pink. This one you got more beautiful women. They got really... Whoa, hold on. Look at this girl. Wow. That's just nice. People just going all over each other's graffiti like a bunch of savage animals and shit. Yeah, look at that. Alright. Yeah, I'm just basically talking about color schemes and complexity. All right. One Love, Supreme Style, 2013. All right, look at this. You got the beautiful world of graffiti and the conflict line. You got this nice girl here with the light in the background. Alley's in Toronto. It's like futuristic style graffiti. Got like the water blue. A lot of colors. Even like, some of these get really big too. They're like 10 feet, 12 feet, 14 feet. And this is just underground style filming. Just walking around in the streets. Here, what we can find. Cheech and Chong, yo, straight up and down. Cheech and Chong up in this motherfucker. Yo, got the rainbow colors. This is really nice. I gotta get a full picture of this. All plain in the sky, yo. Yeah. Alright. We're gonna get all of this one. Look at that. I'll dwell on that one for a minute still. And that's what a real artist would do. Rainbow colors, psychedelic. You got the like watercolors, the tie-dye looking styles. You know, and the portraits, the tripping out. And then you got this shit. And you got this right here. Yo. Look at this girl. There's another piece here back in the day. I guess they changed it. Yeah, this is some real shit. Graffiti in the underground streets of Canada, Toronto, North America. Hip hop, four elements. The visual artwork of these image creators. Alright. One Love. I'm gonna let you get one more look at this one. Cause this one's really nice. She's like tripping in a fantasy world with some like dream crystals around her mind. Yo. Like meditating in peace. Yo, peace to all the spiritual people out there on some righteousness. Keep it positive and worship God. We'll make it to heaven eternally and create forever. See here, we got this trippy psychedelic like green slime type with the blue, the yellow golden rings. See, sometimes you can just draw like shapes and patterns. Like these are just like purple trees, blue trees. That's pretty nice stuff. Look at this, you got the two samurai warriors fighting. Japanese graffiti. Japanese graffiti. This shit's tight, yo. With the orange. Yo. And then we even got this here. This with the purple. The dark reddish purple. Yeah. Yeah, I represent. I draw some graffiti myself, but I stopped drawing because I wanted to MC more. And just some. Look at this nice woman, nice white lady. She's pretty, but you all over her. You got her friend and dude there. Yeah, this is tight. Yeah, alright, alright. Keep it moving, yo. To some street shit. Look at this shit. These blue and black and white lines, yo, this shit's tight. You gotta take this all in. It's mad complex, but it's simple at the same time too. Yo, the big purple K with the old English S and the A, yo. That's tight, eh? Got all these names, yo. Like a motherfucker, yo. Yeah, I got that shit. Got the skull. Some of them rap death in they shit. They rap like the wisdom of the world and the not to like be involved in crime and be evil and not to like hurt people, not to cause violence because it'll lead to death, not to be involved in gangs and shit. Do your own thing, you know, like whether you want to be positive or negative, that's on you. It's smarter to be positive, everybody knows that, but whatever you gotta do, you gotta do. Black culture, arts, look at this, got this black girl right here with a smile. Got the dark forest green.
What about the Chinese flag?
Got the old man here. Yeah, yo, it's like the old hand.
Yeah.
Got the purple and the orange and the yellow and the pink and the... Wow, I never even saw this before. Still, look at all that. This guy gets around sight, man. I got like 4 or 5, maybe 6 pieces of this guy. Got this complex, futuristic, three-dimensional one. Yeah. Yeah, this is tight still. And like, so you can have nudity in art, you can do naked women, show you some titties, some triple X action. See that snake right there? See that motherfucking snake with the fangs? Nigga, look at that shit. This is crazy, nigga. Some next level graffiti. Yeah, got the romantic picture. With the stars and the... And then you could just have some weird, crazy old fucking nut shit. Some psycho fucking crazy scribbly lines. Just some like drawing all over the place. Just making a mass type. Looks like a... stew of vegetable soup or like a... somebody puke on the ground or some shit. Look at that shit. That's just crazy. Alright. Gotta keep it moving. Gotta keep it moving. Supreme style. Represent the Most High. He's an artist. Look at nature. Look at all the things he's made. Pictures. Alright, Joe. That's it. Hey, y'all, right here, we got some, this Queen Street graffiti. Representing downtown Toronto. Got a nice bunch of bombs on some plain black space background. This is really nice right here. Also the yellows and purples and blues and reds. We're gonna get a little closer. We're gonna get a closer for this stuff. And like y'all can check it out, see what they got, bright as a motherfucker. But yo, this is it, yo. Just take it all in. I love purple and red and fuchsia and orange mix and pink. Them's the nice colors. Yeah, it's getting kind of grimy. It's real muddy and dirty out here. See some of these graffiti writers do this shit in like the worst conditions. In the cold. In the rain.
when it's blazing hot. We even got more around the corner here. Alright. More of this Queen Street graffiti. And some of y'all may notice some of these places that I've actually done songs in before. Done songs at in these video locations. Angelic Space Alien, some of it was filmed around here. That was my first DVD. Get over. Look at this. A brown devil. You see that? That's some rugged shit. And then you got this. And it's a fight of devils and angels. You know what I'm saying? Like, a devil is the worst, an angel is the best. Got all this shit here. Just some scribbly, abstract, weird, crazy, three-dimensional, four-dimensional, multi-layered, intricate piece. Albert Einstein. Yeah, you could do portraits of people. You know what I'm saying? Check that out for a minute. Yeah, that's good, eh? True, true. And then you could just do the atomic nucleus atom. You could do like real angled, skinny, slender, sleek, slick, tight, complex pieces. You know what I'm saying? You could do big, fat, crazy, like overdone, hardcore, fat, nasty, dirty, grimy ghetto pieces like this with sick, fat, thick lettuce. You know what I'm saying? It's infinite style, so just do your thing and keep it true. I. One. Here we have the wonderful Toronto skyline. My city. My motherfucking city. And you can check out this forest, emerald, light and dark green piece that is absolutely amazing. Got this girl here, the train, like floral flowers, very beautiful. Nice girl with the green hair. That, take that all in, y'all. Straight up. Like a tribute piece. Yeah. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
it up and down, yo. One love to everybody in the almighty intergalactic universe of the Most High Creator. Peace and love to everybody forever. Fuck war. Fuck violence. Fuck race. Fuck death. All that just bullshit. Be righteous. Do good. Be positive. Think intellectually and intelligently. And be a person that is on the path of spiritual knowledge to get to heaven. You know what I'm saying? And listen to that hip hop, you know what I mean? Yo, we're doing this Supreme Style Conspiracy. Conspiracy Supreme Style. Visual Boy. The Visual Boys chapter. Jared's up in my house. Optimus Prime, yo. Shout out Optimus Prime. I'll give you a quick tour of the Conspiracy Mansion. Optimus Prime, MF2 Records. Bunch of hip-hop, reggae. Abstract blue pieces. You know what I'm saying? Got the Justice League, yo. Y'all gotta keep it clean and fresh and tight, you know what I'm saying? X-Men Mutant Academy. Yo, check this out. I'm really happy I got this. Marvel vs. Capcom 2. Oh, you know what I'm saying, yo. All my video games, yo. You know what I'm saying, yo. Capcom in the house. All the video game players out there. Yo, straight up and down. You gotta play DC vs. Mortal Kombat. I was killing motherfuckers at that shit, doing all sort of combos and shit, you know what I mean? Like, get complex with them, you know? Show them that you've got the skill to play the video games, and like, I got this too. My main motherfucking nigga, Rodimus Prime, yo, check the shit out, yo. Rodimus Prime from Transformers. Yeah. Look who that is, Cyclonus, yo, one evil motherfucker. Yeah, look at that, yeah. Straight up. Got the liquor in effect. Learn about the human body. Yo, alright, we gonna get into this. That was just a little intro. Get this shit on. On like a motherfucker, yo. One love. We gonna do this. Alright. We may have technical difficulties. This is being recorded live and direct. True, we're gonna just talk about Conspiracy's favorite Astro Majesty and legendary album. Yo, here we go. Set it up like this. Supreme Style. I'm gonna even do a freestyle. Yo. Yeah.
Right before I rip it, I live with a thousand in your mind. you a god and for falling in a mouth. Blood on drums, stupid little vibe that is cliche and even fast and you know, all kind of trendy, contemporary. Nah, brother, I'm the original, lyrical, spiritual, metaphysical, technical, typical, individual, and visual, factual and literal. Yo, check it out, my name is Conspiracy, on the mic, rockin' it. In 2013, after the age of Aquarius, yo, a world of divine love for the most high, a god of a let's fly in my style of soul. Take that, I don't even have to try, I'm lost for lazy.
Yo, I know you hate me.
Give me a minute, yo, what's up the rhyme? The roof is infinite, the streets are up the top of the freeway, mental vibration. Yo, why am I Jamaican? Rastafarian, yo man. Shout out to all the people with the colorful fashion and red jewelry that is doing something good for the world, yo man. Little boys and girls, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, that was just a freestyle, but yo, check it out. We're gonna do this right now.
The freestyle.
Yeah, shout out all the producers in the game, all the MCs in the game. These are conspiracy statements after Majesty Legendary albums, you know what I mean? You gotta check this out. Even number one, Conspiracy Theory. Yo, you gotta hear this song, Conspiracy Theory, yo. 12 minutes, 12 seconds of intergalactic intelligence, just leave it at that. Get that, son. Yo, Screw the Underground, I'm going commercial. I did that album in 2001 in Edmonton. That was my first solo album. I had friends. 150 CDs, yo, that was fresh. Shout out LBA, all my cats out in the West Coast, Alberta, British Columbia. I did positive love creation, negative hate destruction. Oh my god. Positive love creation was the positive side. Negative hate destruction was the negative side, obviously. And one's really demonic, one's really angelic. Yo, you gotta check that out. All over other people's beats. Yeah. Number four, a divine life versus free. I did this mixtape on Federal Futurism Records. Shout out my homie in Extra. I won't say his name, but he's a good producer. A Divine Life is just all about righteous positivity in the world and like Earth going from being a 3D to a fifth dimensional intergalactic home planet for people in the galaxy. In the grand universe, you know? Tuesday night movie.
Yo, you should check that out. Shout out my boy Crunk Chris on Legendary Entertainment.
I did this album, Tuesday Night Movies. Had a song, End of Days had a song, Just Before Dawn, it had the song, Die Hard.
Oh, you gotta hear that song, yo, straight up.
Yo, that was flavor. Even more such, it had They Live, it had, Resident Evil, yo, you're not ready for that. It'll come out one day. Shout out my boy, Crunk Chris, Legendary Entertainment. Yo, www.conspiracyamc.bandcamp.com, www.astromagicycreations.bandcamp.com. You go and hear all my music on my website. Yeah. Album number six, The Black Man LP. All black people, black culture, black history, period. Picture of a new on the cover. Spiritual Rebirth, the Rapture Remixture. That's the new version of the album I did with Mindbender on. My album side, it was the Spiritual Rebirth side, if you remember, take back to 1997. Let me get my facts correct. And it was actually a double album with Mindbender and Conspiracy. I was side two. I remixed it. I got a new version. And it's pretty good, yo. Straight up. And then I even got, you gotta hear that, yo. That's like my favorite album ever. I'll show you the covers and stuff one day. Yo, you're gonna see the album. It'll be coming out probably April or May. Maybe even sooner. And then number nine was the first Big Pyramid, my first album, the first album I ever did in hip-hop. I did that in Ottawa, Ontario, and that was like, oh man, it had Cameron Magnanimous on it. Shout out to Next Terrestrial producer. He's like the Dr. Dre of the RZA of the crew. I never was ever disrespected ever. He rules forever, made all our beats. He's dope. And my twin brother, Mind Bender, who's on the album. Things I love is righteous, divine, angel, eternal, immortal, illuminated, eternal life down here on earth. Well, I shout out my favorite MC. Did you get that? Things I love in righteous, divine, angel, eternal, immortal, illuminated, eternal life down here on earth. My favorite MC. Number one, Canadian MC, Canadian celebrity MC, Socrates. Number two, Prevail. Number three, Red One. Yo, shout out to Rascals. Number four, Mad Show. Shout out Swollen Members. Yeah. We just gonna go to Mad Beach. I just had to do that one freestyle. Mad Child, yeah man, you got all those new albums. You got Beautiful Death Machine, you got Dagger Mouth, you got Arm to the Teeth. Yo man, you guys are always putting out those Balance and yo, Bad Dreams, all that stuff, man. You got that TLTD, you know. Organic, always gotta shout out the Toronto homies. Mocha Olio, Legendary Entertainment. Mocha has almost as many albums as me. He had more than me at one point, but now I have more than him. Because I tried, I wrote, I worked, I recorded, I smoked, I drank, I freestyled, I did everything. And I ended up getting like, now I have like about 85, 90 hours. Roundabout, rough estimate, guess. Shout out Noah 23, Spiritual Underground Righteous MC. And he's even a white dude. You don't find those very much. F all those people, white Europeans. Shout out all the righteous Americans and the righteous Africans and the righteous Asians. Shout out the righteous Europeans too. Yo! Adam Bomb. Noah 23 got out, you know, tons of underground songs. Yo man, Astro Consciousness. Adam Bomb, Toronto MC. Top knowledge, yo. Street knowledge. I love that guy, yo. Yeah, freestyle. I seen him back in the days, yo. Came up. My boy, stay next to Terrestrials, yo. I love you, stay algebra. I love you for eternity, yo. In the name of the Most High, you know what I'm saying? Rastafari, brother. Yo. Yeah, shout out my boy Adam Bomb. My boy Mysterio and Avian. Kelron Magnanimous. Actually, his name now is Nick Knox, but I always think of him as Kelron. His real name is Nick Knox. Buck 65, yo, the list goes on, the list goes on. Here's my hip-hop juice that I live. Yo, with a flow, yo, with a rap, yo, with a style, yo, with a way, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean? Yo. When I saw Busta Rhymes in 2005 in Edmonton, yo, I went with DJ Weezer, that shit was crazy. West Edmonton Mall Hall, man. We did, like, so many songs. Another dream, number two. When I opened for Black Thought with Mindbender at Manifest in 2011, yo, that was off the hook, off the chain, off the telephone, pole, off the fucking, off the Richter scale, off the, oh man, off the planet. Serious. Too much, too much. Shout out, Manifesto. I opened for Philip Farley with my band here, Manifesto 2010. That was pretty good. I think Jean Grey was there too. Jean Grey. Shout out all the people I've seen. Shout out Lauren Hill, MC Life, Philip J. Fox, Xavier Banks, even new ones, Nicki Minaj. I like Nicki Minaj. Even though I did that, she tried to kill me in that battle. Eternia. You know, even the old school ones. Jammer 2009, that's team number four. Shout out to you, the Damager. J-Roo the Damager, y'all, all the dumb. Sunrise in the East. Oh man, it was all the best. Back in the 90s. Rock the Bells 2009, Nas, Damian Marley, RZA, EPMD, MOP, Supernatural, KRS-One, King Ross, Look at That Even More. Yo, man, it was wonderful. So many people there. That was the first time I've ever been to Rock the Bells. I still gotta see, like, MOP, Slick, Rick, lots of other groups rock him. Yo, hip-hop is the best for eternity. Let you know that. I'm just letting you know that. I just have to let you know that. Alright? Amen. 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 I was breakdancing with Crazy Legs in Vancouver in 1998. That was a legendary moment. At this club, just like, he randomly showed up and I was there alone. It was a dream. That's why I'm saying hip-hop dream, you know what I mean? Meeting DJ Cuban in Ottawa in 1996. Yo, that was like super extremely amazing. Smoking weed with Helter Skelter. And Dexter Terrestrials in Ottawa in 1998, y'all. We are like, what else? Oh, this was a classic moment. Classic Canadian celebrity moment. But I got voted for the winner to be the winner by Prince Paul for the Rugged Man contest. That was too much, yo. I love that. That was like a heartwarming moment. Yo, the straight up one love, the great thing to hear that song. Set the sun again. And even when I met Casual and going out with Opio from Pizza in Vancouver in 1998 when I was in Van City, Vancouver. Yo, that was legendary. Shout out to Emotions. And Ishgad and Bird of Prey and DD Cascade. Hashtag food, all of them. I done so much stuff in hip hop, I freestyled the south of the site because I've been breakdancing, yo, all of it. I lived in culture forever, yo, as an angel. Here's my dream collaboration before I end this visual boy chapter. Yo, straight up. Check it out. One, Busta Rhymes and Black Thought. Imagine that, if those two were on a real actual album track. Two, Helter Skelter, DPG, the Dog Pound. Imagine if that happened. Three, Eminem and Necro. Imagine if that happened. That would be incredibly imaginary. Number four, RZA and Dr. Dre. Oh, that would be a dream come true. And number five would be conspiracy and apathy. That would be number five. I gotta be hooked up with my boy Apathy. A lot of MCs and social workers. I'm having health problems. I'm cursed by two demons, but I'm fighting them in the name of the Most High. And I'm letting you know that once conspiracy is in perfect health, he will really, really, really be a super supreme style righteous divine angel. I'm 99% there, but, you know, we all go through our trials and tribulations. And in the name of the Creator, Son Yahshua, I will meet this. And you will see so much hip-hop ever and ever and ever of your DJ MC people.